It's in the game.
Thank you.
All right, coming up next, it's a lightweight bout between Conor McGregor and Dustin Poirier. Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor as round one gets underway here. And I got to think, if you're Conor, this fight is happening in a different division. It's happening more than 5 years later. Got to throw out the film on F1, correct?
You have to throw it away. You have to look at this as a different fight. Because the first time, Dustin Poirier was not a champ. He was not a guy that had been to the top of the mountain. Right. Now, Dustin has accomplished so many things. Conor has to view him as a completely different opponent.
And you know Conor McGregor prepares as hard and as well as anyone. He has done his homework as he tries to make it 2-0 in his rivalry with Dustin Poirier.
Well, he has certainly found the range and staying pretty busy here on the feet.
He's being busy, but it's also the timing and the accuracy that's allowing him to land so many attacks.
Poirier gets the takedown following that nice combination. That is one well-rounded fight. Nice job by Dustin Poirier there. Sticks the target and then moves his head off the center line to avoid the comeback shot.
Head off the center line and watch him counter with that beautiful straight left that he throws over and over. Poirier does a better job when he's the guy going forward.
Blocks the shot.
Oh, nice right hand. Look at him drive his shin into the opponent's body with that body kick.
Just missed on the overhand left. Good head movement there. So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Conor McGregor. Circling to his right. Under 2 minutes now to go. Look up. His opponent in a lot of trouble now.
That was Cain Velasquez's punch of choice. Every time he lands that overhand right, he hurt people bad. And this guy has his opponent hurt very badly again.
Pinpoint accuracy on that kick.
No windup, no tell, just a brutal kick.
So a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming. Big punch lands over the top. How's he going to follow this one?
All right, 20 seconds to go in the round.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. When you're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head.
That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, let us look back at some of the action from that previous round. DC punch. All right, here we go with our second round now. Conor McGregor versus Dustin Poirier. Just missing on the high kick there. Nice defense there. Huge block.
Big. Oh. You didn't like that left hand.
He's got him hurt here. Oh, oh. Oh, he might be out. Oh, oh, huge right hand.
Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Back to the feet. Brutal knee to the body.
Nice straight punch.
Timing the shots pretty well here early, DC.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up, keeping busy, being very accurate.
Oh, single collar tie here. And he landed the right hand there. Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position.
So we call on the fight stats here. These are unofficial, but strong numbers. 46 total strikes have now landed for Conor McGregor. And connecting with just a 36% accuracy there against Dustin Poirier. Well, his corner was pretty urgent after round one. A little bit lackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Huge block there.
Right on the button. That's a big connection there for McGregor, DC.
I mean, big strike landed for Ireland's favorite son, Conor McGregor. I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh! In there. His opponent could be out of here soon, DC.
He's almost done. I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, you don't know whether to run, hide, grab, or wrestle. He's confused.
Back to the feet. Now goes in and secures the takedown.
Big punch from the clinch.
And now he's got that tie clinch.
Nice punch, man.
Poirier's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Good series of strikes for him there, staying busy and staying accurate.
I mean, the accuracy is unbelievable.
That shot is blocked by McGregor.
Hey, stop.
All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. A stunner there with the head strike.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Here we go. 5 minutes remain in the fight.
Great punch.
Oh, shot to the body connects there. He hasn't really thrown too many.
This might be the biggest shot of this entire fight. He landed a massive hook to put his opponent on wobbly legs.
Poirier gets hit by that leg kick. May not be a bad idea to start to check some of these. Strike to end this fight. It landed flush. I'm not even sure the opponent wholly saw it coming, and before he could recover, the referee was in to stop the fight. So a huge knockout victory for that fighter here tonight. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was
and here once more, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 36 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout, the notorious Conor McGregor!
Well, we congratulate him on a huge knockout here tonight. He'll probably keep that smile while he's sleeping.